SEO is changing. Things that used to work years ago are no more working, and Google is becoming intelligent. So you need to adopt some of the latest advanced on-page and off-page SEO strategies to get higher rankings and higher traffic. Hey there, this is Akshay Haldor from BloggingX, and in this video you will learn top 14 advanced modern off-page SEO strategies you need to implement right now for increased rankings and traffic. The first off-page strategy is have a proper on-page strategy in place. I know it might sound irrelevant, but having perfect on-page SEO strategy is very important to get the full effectiveness of off-page SEO strategy. You need to have proper interlinking and topical optimization in place. Interlinking refers to that, like, your related blog posts should be internally linked within each other in your site. So I have a separate video on interlinking. I will make sure to include the link in the description. Or if you're on YouTube, the video will pop right here. You need to make sure that proper on-page SEO is in place, because when you build backlinks, for those backlink link juice to spread uniformly throughout your site, proper internal linking and proper site structure is very important. And also, you need to optimize your articles around specific keywords and also keep topical optimization in mind. The second thing is brand building. Branding is the new SEO. If there is no great brand name associated to your blog, then you're missing out on a lot of SEO opportunities. So you may have heard about this example, right? When someone searches for shoes and then he searches for Nike shoes, then Google thinks that Nike shoes is more popular and Nike shoes start ranking above for the generic terms shoes also. So like this, whenever people search for your blog name, mentioning it, explicitly mentioning it, your brand gets a boost when it comes to search traffics and rankings. That's one of the reasons why I recently rebranded my previous Go Blogging Tips to BloggingX. So, and also, if you have a very easy to remember brandable name, it leads to more direct traffic on your site. People will easily remember it. It leads to brand memorability, and they visit your blog directly by entering it in the address bar, which itself is one of the ranking factors when it comes to Google. So branding is the new SEO. And the third factor is inbound links. According to the SEMrush case study, inbound link still is one of the most strongest SEO factor out there. So you need to keep the ART rule in mind, A-R-T. A stands for authority, R for relevancy, and T for traffic. You need to get backlinks that are from authority sites, A, and you need to get backlinks from sites that are relevant to your niche, that is R, relevancy, and T, you need to get backlinks from the sites which likely drive you referral traffic through that backlink. So it matters a lot to Google, because if a particular backlink to your site is driving you traffic, it means that the backlink is relevant and it carries more weightage when it comes to Google. The fourth strategy is competitor backlink analysis. You can make use of tools like SEMrush or Ahrefs. Just enter in any of your competitor URLs. By the way, like, you can treat someone as your competitor if they have low domain authority than your site or low domain ratings than your site. So you need to enter in your competitor URLs in either of SEMrush or Ahrefs or any other tools, and it will display you the backlinks that your competitors are getting. So one hack here you can implement is, like, you can enter in your competitor URL and just tell SEMrush or Ahrefs to display only the newest backlinks that your competitors are getting. And among those latest backlinks, just figure out what are all the guest posts or what are all the, you know, roundups or interviews that they have participated in that led to those backlinks. By that, you can replicate exact those strategies to get you great backlinks. The fifth strategy is zero backlinked content strategy. So tools like SEMrush or Ahrefs allows you to display the posts on your competitor site that is getting lots of traffic but has zero backlinks, right? By that, those keywords would be very low competitive, and if you target on your blog post, then it will also rank without any backlinks or with a few backlinks. But still, zero backlink strategy is great. I am leveraging it day in, day out for all my niche blogs. I just identify what are all the keywords that my competitors are targeting that is getting them traffic without any backlinks. The sixth strategy is guest posting. Guest posting is very effective provided that you're right, doing it the right way. Guest posting, first you need to connect with the site owner, maybe liking his tweet or replying to his any of his Facebook statuses. You need to create relationship with him, and afterwards you need to do prospection and reach out to him with a proven template that you can find on the internet. Like, there are many blog posts on how to create a great guest post template. You need to implement copywriting in your outreach email and email it to your prospects, and don't forget to follow up them at least for the next week after you send your initial email, because follow-ups receive great replies if you are in a niche where they receive guest posts, many guest posts day in, day out. The seventh strategy is backlink gap analysis. So once you make a list of your competitors, you need to figure out what are all the backlinks they all have in common, but your site is not having. You can make use of SEMrush or Ahrefs for this backlink gap analysis. All you need to do is just enter in your competitor domain URLs and enter in your own domain URL for those tools to display you the backlinks that all your competitors have in common, but you don't have. Those are the low-hanging fruits that you can easily acquire because all your competitors have got those backlinks. The eighth one is brand mentions. Brand mentions is one of the Google ranking factors. Even if those mentions do not link to your blog, even if they are unlinked mentions, they carry weightage, because when Google identifies that your brand has been mentioned all over the internet, it makes sense to Google to treat your brand as a popular one and rank it higher in SERPs. And also, you can make use of brand monitoring tools by SEMrush that allows you to monitor all over the internet for your the mentions of your brand. And whenever someone mentions your brand and have not linked to your brand, you can reach out to them and carry out link reclamation. That means you have mentioned my brand but have forgotten to link to my brand. Please do the same. Like, you can outreach them and reclaim your backlinks. And this is called link reclamation when it comes to brand mentions. The ninth strategy is backlink audit. You need to do the backlink audit periodically on your site. There's an awesome tool by SEMrush called Backlink Audit that allows you to pull in your backlink report, the list of backlinks that your site has, and it displays the toxicity of those backlinks. So if the toxicity level as displayed by SEMrush is like medium or high, it means that you need to consider disavowing some of the links to be disregarded by Google when it comes to rankings. If the toxicity score is low, like that of BloggingX, then there's nothing to worry for you. Please do note that you need to take extreme care when disavowing any backlinks, because it may backfire if you're not careful enough and end up disavowing the links that are actually helping you get traffic and rankings on Google. Only disavow very irrelevant, spammy backlinks, especially those backlinks that come with the spammy TLDs, country-specific TLDs or stuff like that. The 10th one is influencer outreach. The moment you publish a great share-worthy content on your blog, you need to outreach the people whom you have featured or linked to in your blog posts. And also, you can make use of tools like BuzzSumo. There, you need to enter in the keyword on which you have published your article, and it will display all the other people who have, all the influencers who have shared similar content in the previous period, right? So you can reach out to them and ask them feedback about your content and ask them to share your content with their audience because of the fact that they love the content and have shared similar content previously. Social media promotion. So you need to regularly share your blog content on social media sites. So you can make use of social media scheduling tools like Hootsuite or Buffer, or you can use Planable, or if you're using SEMrush, it comes with a social media poster. So that helps you to schedule your blog posts promotion of your blog post on social media sites automatically according to the schedule. So you need to schedule the content for your all your social media profiles regularly, so that your social media profiles will receive content on a regular basis, and also you get traffic to your blog on a regular basis from these social media sites. And you need to also remember that the social media promotions or the social media signals that your blog gets is one of the direct ranking factors. Right? Google looks at the social signals of your blog to rank it higher on Google. The 12th strategy is repurposing content. Okay, I said you need to promote your content on social media sites. Okay, so what about the content, right? So you need to repurpose your content. For example, if you ask me, all the blog posts, almost all the blog posts that I publish on BloggingX will be repurposed to videos like this. Right? The content that I'm presenting in this video are already in the textual format on my blog. And I publish this video on YouTube and embed that YouTube link in my blog, so that people who prefer watching videos can skip reading my blog post and watch the video instead. And I also repurpose the blog post, some paragraphs as my Facebook group post, in Facebook, in Twitter, and also Quora answers whenever relevant. So you can also consider creating the slides out of your blog post and upload it to SlideShare, or you can create an infographic for your blog post. So like this, you need to learn repurposing the content. Some people repurpose their blog content as podcasts and upload it to iTunes or Pocket Casts or other platforms. The strategy number 13 is press releases. So press releases is not for backlink building. It's for gaining buzz around your blog or to increase branded search queries. So you need to aim for getting your blog featured on big publications. For that, you need to develop a relationship with journalists, top journalists, or you can make use of some platforms like Help a Reporter Out, Harrow, or you can use some less tapped, less known platforms like sourcebottle.com. So with this, you get emails daily whenever people or journalists want content from other niche specific experts. So you provide them content, they provide you exposure. And you can also make use of press release services, make sure it's legitimate. And also the links should be no follow. It should not be do follow, because it hurts your link profile. It's not, you know, 2010 to get link juice from press releases, right? Make sure those links are no follow. And lastly, the 14th strategy is you need to track your SEO efforts. You need to track the rankings for the keywords. I realized this lately, right? There are many SEO keyword rank tracking tools like rankz.io by my friend Sumit Shah. And you have many other tools like AccuRanker. And even if you're using SEMrush or Ahrefs, they have their own rank trackers. They let you track the rankings of your pages for specific keywords that you have targeted on your blog post. That is very important, guys, because without rank tracking, there's no effective way for you to understand whether your backlink building or your off-page SEO techniques are working as intended. Suppose if a particular blog post is ranking in top third position from last 3 months, and suddenly it dropped in rankings, those rank tracking softwares will notify you so that you can update the content on the blog, or you can implement, you know, proper formatting on your blog post, or you can reconsider the intent, the content intent that you have created on your site. So like this, rank tracking helps you a lot. Make sure you track your seed keywords on these tools, right? So I recommend using rankz.io or AccuRanker. Those are dedicated rank checking softwares out there. All right, guys, hope you loved this video. If you did find this video helpful, hit that like button. And also, if you have any doubts, make sure you leave them in comment section, and please do share this video with your friends, and more awesome videos coming your way.